By the 25th century, Earth's resources were ravaged, consumed, exhausted. Desperate and on the verge of extinction, we cast out into the void of space and discovered rich new worlds waiting to be cracked open and stripped bare. All of Earth became devoted to this effort. The planet crackers were built, the USG Ishimura the first and most famous. Planet cracking became routine. Its spoils kept us alive. Eventually, greedy eyes fell upon Aegis 7. Restricted for centuries for reasons unknown, greed and corruption saw to the demise of caution. There, buried beneath the surface, an artifact. There it is. The red marker. Long lost and long forgotten. The religion I once called my own had found its holy grail, the key to human immortality. Death is not the end. Or so we thought. It did not bring salvation.
Witness the conviction of a true believer!
It brought doom. Marker bred insanity, murder, and chaos. It bred necromorphs. Those who escaped the planet fled to the safety of the orbiting Ishimura.
This is Shuttle CSO4. The colony's overrun. We can't go back.
The scourge released upon Aegis 7 came with them. Within hours, the Ishimura went dark. The corporation dispatched a small repair crew to check on its investment.
Seems like everyone was trying to pack in a hurry.
Among the crew was an engineer, Issac Clark.
Issac, it's me.
He had something special aboard the Ishimura.
I wish I could talk to you.
In the darkness, Issac found death. It was not alien. It was man-made. And it could be used to stop the outbreak. Issac also found Nicole.
Thank you, Issac. I always believed in you.
Dead by her own hand, she was an apparition of the marker. Issac engineered his escape. But everything else was destroyed. Three years later, he wakes in a hospital on Titan Station, an Earth-Gov metropolis on Saturn's largest moon. Issac has survived, but his mind is no longer safe. For the marker changes all.
Thank you. I think I found the exit, but it's way above me. Gravity controls are locked out. Dana!